This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. We're going to continue solving basic proportions, and we're going to do these four problems on this video. Notice the difference is these proportions have decimals in them. So it'll be easier to use a calculator, although you could also just use a piece of paper and do your multiplication and division by hand. So let's do the first problem. Here it is. Now on this one, let's do it without a calculator, even though I said use a calculator to solve for x. So how could I do this one? Well, for one thing, I'm going to notice this is a proportion, and remember that in a proportion, if you have a over b equals c over d, then you can take the numbers diagonally across the equal sign and multiply those together, a times d, and that will equal the other two numbers multiplied together. Remember, this only works in a proportion where there's an equal sign. If it's times, can't do that. It's just a multiplication problem. All right, so let's do that on this problem. And I always look for where the variable is, and that's what I'm going to multiply first. So I see x is multiplied by 3, so I'm going to write 3x equals, and then the other diagonal is the 5.8 times 5.1. 5.8 times 5.1. I'm using parentheses for multiplication so it doesn't get confused with a time sign with a dot. And then we'll divide both sides by 3. Now it's true that you can multiply 5.8 times 5.1 and then do division with 3. I'm going to see if I can cancel first. And if you know your divisibility test for 3, you think of this 5.1 as 51, 3 goes into 51. In fact, it goes in 17 times. So remember how you do this. If this is a whole number down here, 3 into 51 is 17. But you have to move in one decimal place because it was really 5.1. So then I only have to do 5.8. times 1.7. And you could do that any way you want. There's different ways to do multiplication. I'll do the standard way most people do. So 8 times 7 is 56. So it's 6 carry the 5. And that's 35 plus 5 will give you a 40. And then we have 1 times 8. 1 times 5. And I get 986. Then remember what we do is we have to move the decimal in for each of these places, two places total. So our answer is 9.86. So this answer is actually x equals 9.86. That's doing it without a calculator. Now if you had a calculator, it's a little easier. You just put in your calculator 5.8 times 5.1 and then divided by 3. So in your calculator you would enter, you know, depending on what kind of calculator, just 5.8 times 5.1 divided by 3, and you will get the same answer with a calculator. Now in this problem, we didn't need to round. It came out exactly to 9.86. For the rest of the problems, we're going to use a calculator because I've given problems that it unfortunately is not as easy to do. Bigger numbers, lots of decimals. So although you could do this without a calculator, we're just going to try to get how to solve proportions. That's going to be the main idea here. So try this one on your own with a calculator first, and then come back to me. So we've got x times 7.8. So we've got 7.8x equals, and then we're going to multiply those two numbers together, 29 times 2.31. Now, you don't need to do this multiplication now. You could always wait and do everything in your calculator in one step. So I'm going to divide both sides by 7.8. And then we're simply going to enter that in the calculator. So in your calculator, you want to put 29 times 2.31 divided by 7.8. And what comes up in the calculator, my calculator has 8.58846. It goes on and on and on. Notice that we're rounding to the nearest hundredth. That's two places after the decimal point. So we want to cut it off right here. Now, since There's an 8 after the hundredth place. We're going to round this up. So instead of 8.58, it will be 8.59. But it doesn't equal that. It's approximately equal. And so I do a little squiggly line. It's 8.59. So that's x to the nearest hundredth. All right, here's the second third problem, actually. So go ahead and try this one on your own. All right, so I find the x. It's diagonally with the 41. So we've got 41x equals, and then we'll multiply those two numbers together, the other diagonal, 0.15 times 3.9, and we'll divide by 41. And of course, if you were doing this longhand, you would actually have to do 15 times 39 and figure out that the decimal goes in three spaces, and then you'd have to divide by 41 and do long division to at least three places after the decimal so you could round to the nearest hundredth. With a calculator, we'll just enter it. 0.15 times 3.9 divided by 41. And in my calculator, I get 0.01426, etc. What matters is that I have to really go look at the third number here. It's a 4, so it does not round up. So this is rounded to the nearest hundredth, approximately 0.01, which is 1/100. By the way, when you use a calculator, I always put my numbers in twice as a double check. So I would probably do this two times to make sure I didn't accidentally enter something incorrectly. All right, next problem. Again, try this one on your own first. Put the video on pause. Work it. Round to the nearest hundredth. All right, so we're looking for x here, and it's across diagonally from 46.1. So at 46.1x equals 21 times the 3.8, right? Because those are the other two numbers. And then we'll divide by 46.1. And we're going to also approximate that. So on our calculator, we want to put in 21 times 3.8 and then divide by 46.1. And the calculator, I get 1.7310, etc. So again, I'm going to just keep it at 1.73. I'm not going to round up. So this is approximately 1.73. And there you have it. So we've done just some more proportions, more basic proportions. But we're using a calculator to help us with these messy arithmetic problems. If you want to see what happens if you have some problems that have some fractions in it, go to the next video, problems like this. Maybe you might have 2/3 over an x equals 5 over 4, something like that. I'll go over problems like this on the next video on basic proportions. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.